they give a scenario of a newborn, okay, then it is mostly vitamin K deficiency. Okay, there may be history of the child didn't receive any drug or was born at home, or like the child received oral vitamin K, which is not as effective as the intramuscular one. So this coming to the capacity, spirometry. Okay, spirometry is very important for your exam. Very important. I mean, each and every session, not I should say every session, but leaving one session apart, they usually ask this chart. This whole diagram you need to remember. Okay, what they usually do, they hide the name of the capacities and the volumes. Okay, and then they ask which is FRC, which is RV. They will give you a number like this. What is number one? Okay, they will give you option. Inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume, tidal volume, and all. Okay, so you need to remember this chart well along with the definition. Okay, tidal volume. What is tidal volume? We all know that. What is tidal volume? It is the
amount of air inspired or expired in each respiration.
Yes, in each respiratory cycle, whatever the air is moving in and out of the lungs is nothing but the tidal volume. Okay, so they usually don't ask about the tidal volume. Okay, but they are more concerned about the other definitions. Okay, so like inspiratory reserve volume. Okay, what is inspiratory reserve volume? It is the maximum volume of air which is inhaled from end inspiration. After the end of inspiration, it is the maximum volume of air inhaled. Similarly, ERV, expiratory reserve volume, is the maximum volume of air exhaled from end expiration. Okay, so this is ERV. So to remember this, this one is ERV and this one is IRV. Okay. And what is vital capacity? It is the sum of IRV, tidal volume, and ERV. Okay. Vital capacity by definition is, it is the largest volume which is measured on complete exhalation after full inspiration. Okay. So this is the vital capacity. Okay. Now we have another thing which is known as residual volume. Okay. This is the only parameter, only volume that is not measured by spirometry. Yes. It cannot be measured by spirometry. It is the volume which remains in lung after maximum forceful expiration. Okay. So whatever thing which comprises of the residual volume cannot be measured by the spirometry, like FRC, like TLC. Okay, FRC is ERV plus RV.
RV.
Yes. So what is FRC? It is the volume of air in lungs at resting and expiration. See here, the expiration just ended. Okay, expiration ended. Now whatever is left in the lung is functional residual capacity. Okay, so residual volume, important point is, it is not measured by spirometry. And when can this residual volume be increased? In which disease?
Asthma.
Yes, asthma. In asthma, residual volume will increase because of air trapping. Okay, this is very important. So we are done with this volumes and capacities. Also, FRC won't be measured by spirometry because it is the sum of ERV plus RV. Okay. And also total lung capacity.
Hello, hello, doctor.
Yes.
Hello, doctor. I can hear from residual volume, which is increased in asthma because the sound is not clear at that time.
Okay, residual.
Will you please repeat?
Okay, yes. Residual volume, I was saying, it is the value is increased in asthma. Okay, the residual volume increases in asthma because of air trapping that happens in asthma. Okay, this was what I said. And I again repeated the thing, because FRC involves residual volume and ERV, it cannot be measured by spirometry. Similarly, TLC also involves residual volume, so we can't measure it by spirometry. Okay, this was all about this graph. So now coming to the lung function test. Before knowing this lung function test, you should know there are two kinds of graph plotted. Okay, so whatever volume capacities which we have talked of, we will now discuss in this lung function test. Okay, so suppose there are two kinds of graph. Okay, one is the volume time graph and the another is the flow volume loop. Okay, flow volume loop and volume time. First we will discuss the flow volume loop. This is a normal flow volume loop. Okay, so I will draw something and then okay, this is a blank page. So this is flow volume loop. Okay, so this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. Okay, in x-axis I am taking
flow.
Yes, in x-axis I would be taking flow, and in y-axis I would be taking volume. Okay, so suppose a child comes into your clinic and we send him for spirometry. So what he does, he takes the mouthpiece and then blows it out. So he will inspire. Okay, this is inspiration, and then he will expire. Okay, so this will be the a loop will be obtained during spirometry. This is for inspiration and the above is for expiration. Okay, so I will change the color here. Okay, now if we measure from here to here, this will